have another doctor's appointment today. So since my doctor's office is in New Braunfels, I stopped to see Reba for lunch. All sorts of pistachio desserts. I love pistachio ice cream. I'm just a pistachio fanatic. I think I've had it before, but let's pretend like we haven't and try it again. Let's go pick up these kids and get them in the pool. Get them to learn how to swim so I don't have to stress about this anymore. I'm good at time management. No, I'm not.
They want you to list them in alphabetical order going down. So you'll start with green here. Green. Well, good morning, or whatever time it is that you're watching this. Let's see, that's good. I'm getting ready. Morgan is here and helping with the girls right now. I have another doctor's appointment today. I am actually seeing a urologist today because every time I have been into the doctor's office ever since it started when I had my miscarriage for Cody. There's always blood in my urine, like always. So every time the test comes back, we get like a, every time the test comes back, it'll be like negative for a UTI, but always positive for blood in the urine. So this last time when I went over to the GYN, they were convinced that I had an infection because of the blood in the urine, but then all my infection tests came back clear. So my primary said, you know, since we're going to be like moving forward with a hysterectomy, that because of the blood in the urine, we should just see a urologist and talk to them about that to make sure there's nothing that like is going on that we're missing, and just kind of like rule that out. So I have that appointment today, and I'm basically just gonna tell them exactly like what, well, they'll have like a referral from my doctor, but you know, they ask you all the same questions 300 times. So I'm just gonna basically tell them about the blood for the last 3 years or so. And then also about like the burning, which could be from the adenomyosis. By the way, if you guys don't watch my Instagram, which actually I know that there is at least one person on here who does not because they don't have Instagram. Okay, thanks, honey. Bye. That doesn't have Instagram. I finally got an actual diagnosis for what's going on with the bleeding. It's called adenomyosis. I went to a new OB. Or a new GYN to talk about, you know, getting a second opinion. And when they did the ultrasound, they were able to see it right away, like on the screen. So that was relieving that somebody finally saw a reason causing it, but it also kind of like opened up a whole other door, which is what I was saying just a couple seconds ago about how I was like, we're moving forward with hysterectomy. So with adenomyosis, the only like cure to it is a hysterectomy. A lot of people will try an IUD, or I don't, which I just don't want an IUD. A lot of people will try an IUD or they will do an ablation, but the success rate of it, it doesn't last. They're not like, they don't last is what where I was going with that. The new GYN that I saw, she said that it looked severe enough to where she doesn't think an ablation would even work. And I just don't want an IUD. Like, I'm 33, Nick has a hysterectomy, and I just don't want an IUD. And so with adenomyosis, what it means is that the tissue of the inside of your uterus is growing into the muscle. So it causes bleeding, abnormal bleeding, pain, And I just mentally, the idea of that going on in my body, I just kind of feel like it needs to come out, because in my mind, I'm like, that's just a ticking time bomb of like festering mess that, in my opinion, is a ticking time bomb that I think should come out, that will make me feel better. But I say that, and then I have second thoughts like almost immediately, like that I don't want it out, because you hear horror stories about people who've had, it's a partial, they wouldn't take my ovaries, but you hear horror stories about people who have had it, even a partial, and then they end up having to have their ovaries removed later, or it affects their hormones, or all of these different things. But then there are people who like will say like it's the best decision they ever made, like they can't imagine like life without having had the hysterectomy. So I have mixed feelings, obviously. And so me going to the urologist is just kind of like a precautionary thing, just to make sure that there's nothing else that we're missing that has also been festering for the last 3 years. Because I'm not kidding, every single time I've gone to the doctor and they've done a urine test, blood, it comes back positive for blood. So that needs to obviously be figured out. So that's what I'm doing today, and that's what I'm getting ready for. So I will be back when I'm done getting ready.
So since my doctor's office is in New Braunfels, I stopped to see Reba for lunch. And we're having our soup. I got the ginger salad here, which is phenomenal. What is this place called?
A-Tan
New Braunfels. Phenomenal soup and salad. And we're eating our rolls, which I'll show you all our rolls in a minute. But I was like, I can't go to New Braunfels without telling Reba that I'm gonna be here.
Because I would have been mad.
Yeah. And I normally have the kids when I'm here. So we're having lunch together. It's very nice. Cowboy roll and what's yours?
I don't remember.
Mine has crawfish on it.
Mine has crawfish in it.
Oh, it's spicy, but I like it.
What is it?
Mine has shrimp tempura, cucumber, obviously the mayo, and then the crawfish.
Okay, I'm leaving now. I just left the urologist, which I didn't really like, no offense, I just didn't really like the one that I saw. But she said that I don't have any blood in my urine today, which is awesome, but also so crazy considering every single test, although I will give an explanation for that in a minute. Considering every time I go to the doctor, they come in all puzzled saying, oh, there's blood in your urine, there's blood in your urine. But they don't look at it under a microscope. So at the urologist, they'll look at the blood under a microscope. Gosh, we need AC on. Okay, there we go. They'll look at it under a microscope to see red blood cells. For doctor's offices, they'll just do the little dips, and the dipsticks will say, oh, there's blood in your urine, right? But they do it more in depth here. So I'm coming back in 3 weeks. She wants to just check one more time to make sure that it wasn't a fluke today and that the blood comes back or whatever.